Now, let's assemble the rows. First, bend one end of flower rod with pliers. Take out this big piece and fix the yarn tails to this position with hot melt glue. Then, fix the bent end of the rod on this end of the fabric with hot melt glue. Only squeeze the glue to the bottom of the fabric. Wrap a petal around the flower rod. Try your best to keep the top of each petal at the same height. Only the top of the last petal can be fixed with a little glue. Take out this calyx with a long yarn tail. Pass the flower rod through the center of the calyx. Adjust the position so that we can cover the joint position on the flower by sticking the calyx on it. Wrap around the flower rod with yarn tail. Wrap about 6 to 8 centimeters, and you can add a little more glue for fixation. Then the leaves. Wrap the wire with a yarn tool. The length of widening is about 5 centimeters. Wrap around the leaves with yarn tear to combine them together. Then continue to wrap the leaves and the flower rod together by winding yarn tool. Take out the thin iron wire. Fold it in half. Also, wrap the paddle around the wire with hot melt glue. Repeat the same work with another calyx. Place the two roses at a different height. And the leaves. Add some glue for reinforcement. Keep winding to the end of the flower rod. Add some more glue when you reach the end of the rod. Make some adjustments. The double-headed rose is completed.